Hello, I greet dear friends. In this video, we want to explore refrigeration fundamentals as another capability of our team. In fact, we want to delve into the Joule-Thomson process, which is the basis of refrigeration. When the flow pressure decreases adiabatically under suitable conditions, the Joule-Thomson effect can lead to temperature reduction. Alright, in this video, gases such as R134a, propane, methane, and nitrogen are under review. In fact, in this video, we aim to understand the Joule-Thomson effect well. Alright, let's delve into Aspen Hysys. Excellent. In the component list section, we add the mentioned items in the problem statement. Please note that by entering appropriate phrases in the search box, the desired component will be visible. Each of the added components is used for a specific refrigeration processes. In fact, depending on your specific project, you need to enter your components. Alright, after specifying the components, we need to enter the fluid package section, which is still in red. In this section, we select the Penck-Robinson equation of state. Excellent. No more issues. Alright, we enter the simulation section and drag the model palette window to the right side of the screen. To investigate the effects of throttling and the Joule-Thomson effect, we select the pressure control valve. With a double left click, we enter the pressure control valve window and select stream 1 and 2 as input and output. Now we need to specify the composition of the inlet stream to the valve. For this purpose, we go to the composition tab and set the mole fraction of R134a to 1. We consider the remaining mole fractions as 0, meaning both stream 1 and consequently stream 2 are entirely R134a. Now, in the conditions section, we set the inlet and outlet pressures to 20 and 2 respectively. We also assume the mass flow rate of the stream to be 1000 kilograms per hour. Next, we enter the inlet temperature as 25 degrees Celsius. Excellent. With this, the temperature cools from 25 degrees to about minus 10 degrees Celsius. Now, in the flowsheet modify section, check pressure and temperature to display. Excellent. The Joule-Thomson effect is clearly observable. To display mole fractions and determine the composition, we enter the table, the show table. We clear the remaining parameters to only display the composition. Select the mole fraction filter and in the master component mole fraction section, choose the desired components. Note that with this action, we aim to display the composition in the flow sheet as well. As you can see, in one frame, all process specifications are observable. In fact, in this frame, the Joule-Thomson effect for R134A is fully observable. Now here, instead of R134A, we set the propane mole fraction to 1 and consider the remaining mole fractions as 0. With this action, it's observed that the temperature is further cooled, reaching about minus 25 degrees Celsius. Dear friends, it's worth mentioning that if we need a strong Joule-Thomson effect, it's better for the inlet flow to be closer to liquid. Otherwise, for example, for nitrogen at ambient temperature, meaning when the gas is the inlet flow, the Joule-Thomson effect won't be desirable. Yes, here, the temperature has significantly decreased. Now, let's consider the inlet flow entirely nitrogen as saturated liquid. To do so, remove the temperature and set the vapor fraction to zero. This state equals saturated liquid. Now if we cool a few degrees below this temperature, we will have subcooled liquid. For example, if we consider a temperature of minus 160 degrees, it is observed that the temperature is well cooled and the Joule-Thomson effect is significant. So remember that the closer the flow is to liquid before the pressure reducer, the stronger the Joule-Thomson effect will be. Now let's focus on entirely saturated liquid and set the vapor fraction to zero instead of temperature. With this action, if we change the composition of the inlet flow, Hysys automatically considers saturated liquid for us. This time, we consider the inlet flow entirely methane. Excellent. As you can see, Hysys has calculated the inlet temperature. In fact, at 20 bars, the temperature of methane in saturated liquid state is around minus 107 degrees Celsius. It's also observed that the Joule-Thomson effect has cooled the temperature by 50 degrees. In fact, if we can somehow cool methane to below minus 107 degrees using this valve, we can further cool it by 50 degrees. This phenomenon is the basis of refrigeration processes briefly discussed in this video. In fact, with pressure reduction under suitable inlet conditions, we can effectively reduce the temperature using a pressure control valve. We look forward to your projects.